Howdy folks, I'm Scoryth, the Crimson Renegade, and welcome to a special video where I'm going to take a look at the conferences of E3. Specifically, this video is going to revolve around the SquareEnix conference. Before I get into that, let me explain why I'm doing this, in case you're curious. Before E3, I did a video on what I was looking forward to seeing at E3, back in May, before E3 came out in June. And I'm going to post a few videos for some of the conferences that were done at E3. And kind of, I'm not going to go through the entire conference on a video, but I'm going to like pick and choose like different games that I see and stuff, and just kind of give my opinion on what I see and stuff like that. And that's what I want to do here. But I'm going to be starting with the SquareEnix conference. I want to give credit to GameSpot Trailers, because that was the channel that I got these videos from. So without further ado, let's get into the SquareEnix conference. Like I said, this is the SquareEnix conference. I have seen a few videos based on different games that are in each of the conferences, but I haven't watched the entire conference of any one of these things. So I'm going to start with Final Fantasy VII. So yeah, I'm gonna be commenting on this one. Remake, there it is. There's Aeris. Just like the beginning of the original VII. Now, I have to admit, unlike her portrait in Final Fantasy VII, Aerith actually looks pretty in this game. Her portrait in Final Fantasy VII, the original, I don't think she's that pretty. I really don't. There's Cloud. So what kind of bugs me about this part right here is it looks very much like the E3, or the tech demo they did for the PlayStation 3 way back when. It looks so much like that... That tech demo, so it's kind of like, I still don't think Final Fantasy VII Remake is real, but it is. That pretty much I've seen before from other videos and stuff, so.
Remaking Final Fantasy VII has allowed us to dive much deeper into the world and its characters than ever before. The game design was optimized for this title as well, and we anticipate 2 Blu-ray discs worth of gameplay content.
Jesus.
The first game in this project expands on the story of Midgar and is such an elaborate retelling that it has become a solid standalone game in its own right.
Midgar itself is going to be its own game? Damn.
Through the content we are about to unveil today, and through all that we have yet to unveil, we will not disappoint your expectations. Your reunion with the Final Fantasy VII you know is near.
Reunion, cute.
To newcomers who never played the original, we present to you a completely new Final Fantasy and a perfect starting point to explore the world of Final Fantasy VII.
Please welcome Neil Pabone, Senior Manager, Product Marketing, Square Enix.
So, Neil is here to introduce you and walk you through gameplay.
Thank you, Katase-san. All right, everyone. Let's mosey.
Really?
Final Fantasy VII Remake features a hybrid gameplay system that merges real-time action with strategic, command-based combat. For starters, each press of the square button is a swing of Cloud's Buster Sword. Cloud attacks, dodges, and blocks all in real time. His standard attacks do some damage, but they barely scratch the surface.
They're probably going to explain it, but it looks like there's a piece of material already in his Buster Sword there. Looks like the material is actually in the weapon.
Cloud needs to be tactical. He needs ATB. 2 ATB bars are displayed in the lower right.
These 2 ATB bars.
Over time, but fill much faster as Cloud lands standard attacks.
Okay. And that's like a complicated system.
Full, you can enter tactical mode, where time slows to a crawl, and you have the opportunity to choose actions from the command menu. Katase-san, I've had the pleasure of seeing quite a bit of the game, but tactical mode never gets old for me. I could just sit here all day long and watch this beautiful slow motion action.
I think the audience would like to see more. Isn't that right, everyone?
Fair enough. Good point.
Katassi knows how to talk to the fans.
Once in tactical mode, you can choose to perform various abilities, such as Cloud's Braver attack.
That's a limit break. Okay.
Using an item in battle will deplete an ATB charge, and if Cloud has the right materia equipped,
I just said that.
MP, he can use ATB charges to cast spells. Of course, this being a remake, we're sure to see some familiar faces.
Baird, of course. I think I saw a piece of material in his gun there too.
Is able to target enemies at a distance. Barrett's standard attacks generate ATB charges similar to Cloud, but his abilities are entirely different. Switching between characters in combat is done with a single button press, which makes rotating through party members a snap. Speaking of other party members, okay. Katassi-san, when are we going to see Tifa in action?
Maybe soon.
So you know some English. Maybe soon. Okay.
To fight even when you're not controlling them directly, but it's up to you to choose how and when ATB charges are used. You can maximize your effectiveness by switching between characters or issuing commands to characters with full ATB bars.
Okay, I like how that sounds. I like how that sounds so far. I like how they're kind of combining Final Fantasy 15 with Final Fantasy 7. We get the classic turn-based style. We can slow time down and strategically choose your attacks and your items and your actions. But you've also got the action-based of Final Fantasy 15. That sounds like a very good a hybrid combo. It combines like Katase said, for fans that maybe have not have played the original 7, but maybe have played 15, that'll be familiar to them. And then for older players like me who have played the original, it combines the likeness of 15 with the strategies of 7, which we are familiar with. So I like how they do this. What they're talking about sounds good. Now, will it deploy like they said? You know, we'll have to see if they actually announce a release date, which we'll see.
Focus gauge that fills up as you do damage. When the gauge is full, the enemy becomes staggered, and you'll deal bonus damage.
Staggered? So they take this a little bit from Final Fantasy 13 as well.
And allows players to enjoy battle while taking the time to think strategically. For players who prefer fast-paced action, abilities and spells can be bound to shortcuts for immediate execution.
Like Kingdom Hearts. So they're really combining a lot of the best games. That's good. Again, we've got to see if it executes properly, but it sounds good.
That's right. The game has been made so that you can choose how to play. I hope players get excited about this.
Well, that's a brief introduction to combat in Final Fantasy VII Remake, and we look forward to showing you a whole lot more in the coming months. For now, let's see how Cloud and Barret do against a more formidable foe.
Like the guard scorpion? I guess we're going to see the boss right here, aren't we?
You double crossing.
Or Barret's blaming Cloud? Yeah, that's the guard scorpion, all right. Looks like I did that in Mobius Final Fantasy.
It's on you.
The enemy's on the wall. Okay, I like what I'm seeing so far. Yeah, they didn't have a barrier on the original one either.
So what's your brilliant plan, genius?
I like the banter between Cloud and Barret. There's the tail laser. Oh, there's cross slash. Run, maybe? Okay, she's going everywhere. Oh, wow, they swear. All right, I'm impressed by what I've seen so far. Let's hope it plays as good as it seems.
Welcome.
Like, this is the same one I've seen. I've seen the short version as they were talking about. I don't know if I've seen the long version of this yet. There's Loveless, so I like that it pans out just like it did in the original Final Fantasy VII. At least there are touches here and there that throw back to the original. That's what's going to appeal to people like me who have played the game or played the original game. Like the pan out of Midgar here.
These sewer rats appear to call themselves Avalanche, sir.
I guess that was Heidegger. There's Jesse on the back of a bike. Looks like you do a lot more exploring than you could before.
You think he's a keeper?
Oh my god. Well, they're doing an entire Blu-ray disc of Midgar alone. I guess they're gonna have to expand on the exploration.
Y'all gotta look at the bigger picture here. Nothing worth fighting for was ever won without sacrifice.
I really wish Barrett would lose the sunglasses. I don't like them personally. Wow.
Have you been a good girl?
I heard you're having second thoughts.
I know we have to think big if we're going to make a difference. But not like this. I feel trapped.
She looks good.
My turn.
There's obviously a melee fighter. Oh, there's Eris with her staff. There's Sahajans from the sewers after escaping from Don Corneo's place. Inside Shinra building. Wow. Yeah, there's apps.
Got you now.
That was Somersault. Oh, there's Airbuster. Oh, Cloud. I saw Cloud had Art Edge. Did you see that? Back it up just a second here. I'm going to back this up just a second here. Right, here's our Buster. Now watch when the explosion happens behind them. Okay, look right there. Look at this. This is the hard edge. There's a timer while fighting Airbuster. Oh.
Cloud, I have a favor to ask of you. Run away. You have to leave. You have to leave.
You bastard!
Hold on to that hatred.
What did Sephiroth say there? You run away, you have to run away? Okay. I'm liking what I'm seeing. Oh, shit! 3/3/2020. There's a release date. March 3rd, 2020. Well, I know what I'm going to be scheduling my time off at work for. This is Kingdom Hearts. All right. So, the coat wards off darkness. That's young Xehanort, which means he's still alive, goddammit. Okay, that's got to be Zigbar. You can tell by his mannerisms. That's Zigbar. Or, what was it? Lushu, is that what they called him at the end of Kingdom Hearts 3? Awful way. I realize just how necessary I am. Oh, you're playing as Riku and Aqua there. That's Roxas. You get to play as Roxas? This must be the DLC that they were talking about. Okay, so we're back in We're back in, what's that area? Zigbar. Who are you? There's, okay. I was right, that was Zigbar. Alright. Doesn't make a difference to me anyway. I'll just keep playing dumb. Question is, who are you? Luxor? Remind? Kingdom Hearts 3 DLC coming this winter. Okay. There it is. Alright. Not much information to go on there, but alright.
Please welcome.
Game about mannequins, this ought to be good. Okay. Mannequins and zombies, alright. I assume they're zombies. Okay, so it's Mirror's Edge meets zombies. That's what we're doing so far, other than parkour, at least just in this video. Well, that backflip, that foot flip or whatever that is, that's really gonna fuck with me if I ever play this. Whatever this is, I mean, it looks like it's just another part. It looks like a Mirror's Edge with zombies parkour game. There's a little fighting in this, isn't there? Whee! Yeah, but that was a fun trip. Oh, Dying Light. The first Dying Light was the same way? I'm gonna also never play Dying Light. Okay. Gears of War Judgment and Bulletstorm. Okay, so some kind of third-person shooter, I'm guessing. Holy fuck! Outriders. That looks impressive. What was that big fucking thing in the background? Okay. I'll go. The big monster thing impresses me. All right. Final Fantasy VIII. What are they doing with VIII? Arrives remastered for this generation. A remastered Final Fantasy VIII. Admittedly, I've only played Final Fantasy VIII like maybe a couple of times. If they're actually going to remaster, bring it to like the PS4 or something, I might actually play it a little sooner than I thought. I'm not that familiar with it, so it's going to be. I mean, I'm familiar enough with the story, but I'm not familiar enough with the strategies and the mechanics of the game to do like a step-by-step walkthrough. So it's going to be kind of just me playing the game semi-blind, even though I know the story, I know where I'm going and how to get to places, but I couldn't give you guys a step-by-step walkthrough, one as good as, like, say, I did for Final Fantasy VII. But, okay, Final Fantasy VIII Remastered. Okay, alright, coming 2019. Alright. Okay. And that was Square Enix's conference. That's where, those are the, what you saw were the games that I was interested in, I commented on. Mostly I was impressed by what I saw with Final Fantasy VII, obviously. I like what I see. I like how they described what was going on. Now let's just hope that what they described actually plays as well as it seems. We'll find out. We'll find out come next March. And of course, I'm also pretty excited about Final Fantasy VIII Remastered. I mean, I assume it's probably going to look similar to the way Final Fantasy X Remastered did. X had a little bit more of an advantage because Final Fantasy X's remaster was Final Fantasy X came out on the PS2, so it was already on a better engine and stuff. So Final Fantasy VIII is probably going to look a lot more rough than Final Fantasy X did. But I'm interested to see that, and I'll be glad to play that. So that'll do it for the Square Enix conference. My look at the Square Enix conference. I know it didn't show very much. It wasn't a whole lot that I was really interested. Really took me. The only I think the only new game that they showed that wasn't like a remaster, remake or something that really caught my attention. That I really wanted to do. Really wanted to play. Let me say it like this. I didn't actually show this video, but one of the videos they showed was Life is Strange 2, and I haven't played Life is Strange 1 yet. I want to, but I haven't played it yet, so I didn't bother showing that trailer because I kind of skipped it because I didn't want any spoilers in case there were any like references to the first game that I hadn't seen yet, you know. So Life is Strange was one of the games that was in the conference that I didn't show that I am interested in because I haven't played the first one yet. I didn't bother showing it. But the only other new game that I did show that I was interested in was Outriders. That looks like it's going to be pretty good. That giant monster in the background, whatever the hell that big thing was. Damn! All right. Well, that'll do it for my look at the Square Enix conference. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to, let's just say this first. As always, I'd like to extend a special appreciation to the men and women of the United States military, both at home and overseas, as well as police officers and firefighters around the country. Without you guys doing what you do, I would not be free to do this. So thank you very much. You guys are true heroes. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out the links at the end of this video for more of my stuff. And I'll be doing some more videos coming up as soon as I get through editing them and stuff. I'll upload them as soon as I can. But the some more conferences that I am interested in doing from the E3 of 2019. Again, this has been the Square Enix Conference. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Scoryth, the Crimson Renegade. I'll see you later.